This section will provide a short introduction to common system problems and their symptoms. There are three main causes of hydraulic problems. Contamination, such as dirt, water, air, or that the fluid itself may be contaminating the system if its additives have broken down. Heat. This can be caused by internal leaks, low oil level, or a faulty cooler. Leaks, caused by broken pipes, seals, etc. These problems can cause operational problems, such as choked pump inlet strainer, pump slippage or leakage, internal leakage in system components, sticking of system valves and actuators, blocking of system valves and actuators. There can also be other problems like solenoids not operating, electrical source not operating, relief valve, counterbalance valves, etc. set wrong, human error. External leaks are usually easy to find. Internal leaks, however, can be difficult to locate. Normally, a component with a high rate of internal leakage will be very hot. Leaks can affect hydraulic system operation in three ways. Actuators move slowly. Maximum available system pressure may be reduced. Actuators may move when they should not. Fluids under pressure flowing through leaks will generate heat. Heat will cause the deterioration of synthetic and rubber components. It also reduces fluid lubricity, which will cause metal parts to wear, which will in turn result in even more oil leakage. Here are some troubleshooting hints. Click on the hot spots. Noisy pump. Clean inlet strainer. Check inlet piping for obstruction. Oil viscosity too high. Operating temperature too low. Breather choked. Low oil level. Air in oil. Loose or damaged intake pipe. Worn or damaged shaft seal. Worn or sticking vanes. Worn or damaged gears and housing. Shaft misalignment. Worn bearings. Low or irregular pressure. Contaminants in fluid. Worn or sticking relief valve. Valves partially open. Pressure control setting too low. No pressure. Low oil level. Pump drive reversed or not running. Pump shaft broken. Relief valve stuck open. Full pump volume bypassing through faulty valve or actuator. Actuator fails to move. Faulty pump operation. Directional control valve not shifting. Operating pressure too low. Worn or damaged cylinder or hydraulic motor. Mechanical bind. Slow or irregular operation. Air in oil. Low oil level. Viscosity too high. Internal leaks. Pump drive too slow. Irregular feed rates. Air in oil. Faulty or dirty flow control valves. Overheating of system. Cooling water shut off or heat exchanger clogged. Continuous operation at relief valve setting. Excessive slippage or internal leakage.